Okay, so finally, here's a quick tutorial on how to use Chat GPT, especially for scheduling. First of all, if you haven't done so already, the URL for Chat GPT is chat.openai.com. I should also add that I am using Chat GPT Plus, which is the paid version of Chat GPT. I think it runs like $20 a month or something. But it's important to have this because it allows you to use GPT-4 rather than GPT-3.5. And GPT-3.5 is what you use on the free version, on the free accounts. And it doesn't do anywhere near as good with scheduling stuff as GPT-4 does. So, watch this video, think about whether or not this is something you might find useful enough, especially to pay, I think it's like $20 a month for or something like that. But for now, well, with the I should add too, with the paid version, you get 25 messages every 3 hours on GPT-4, and that's a temporary limitation right now because they're trying to get the server expanded enough that it can handle more load. So in order to keep it from choking up too much, this is what you get. With the paid version, and with the paid version, you also get unlimited access to GPT 3.5 and priority access as well. With the free version, a lot of times you'll try to use GPT 3.5 and you'll have to wait 20, 30 minutes for server space to free up for you to do that because they're giving priority access to the paid members. Okay, so now the boring stuff's out of the way. So let's talk about how we actually use it to make schedules. So the first thing that you're going to want to get used to with GPT is you're not writing prompts the way that you would normally write a prompt for a computer. You really need to think about this more in terms of how would you give instructions to a human being? Because that's how GPT-4 processes information. It is natural, it functions on a natural language processing model, which means you talk to it the way that you talk to a human being. That's going to take some getting used to. It seems like an easy thing when I'm saying it, but it's really going to take you some getting used to, and playing with it is really the only way that's going to happen, because what you'll notice is you'll start getting used to all of the different ways that you can not just write prompts, but then you can get it to expand on things or ask it questions or get it to add things to the output that it's created. And I'm going to show you some of that right now. So, all right, you wanted to make a schedule, for example. Let's say you've got four employees and you want to schedule them to work on a rotating schedule Monday through Saturday, something like that. And I might not use hours this time. We'll just have to see. Well, we can do that actually. We'll do that. Okay, so, well, I'm just going to start with so. All right, here we go. I have four employees, Roger, Jeff, Jessica and Sally. They each need to work, let's say, 30 hours per week. Each shift is 10 hours. You can modify this. Like, I'm using something relatively simple here, but if you wanted to, you could specify like Monday shift is 5 hours, Tuesday shift is whatever. You can play with that. So we're going to say they each need to work 30 hours per week. Each shift is 10 hours. Roger cannot work on Tuesdays. Sally, well, let's do another sentence here. Cannot work on Wednesdays. And Jeff cannot work on May. Let's see, let's make sure we get a date within the proper, let's just say May 4th. Cannot work on May 4th because he's going to celebrate the Force Day, Star Wars Day. All right, so and Jeff cannot work on May 4th. So we're still running in the very relatively simple grounds here. Okay, generate a schedule starting on May 1st and ending 31st with a work week of Monday through Saturday. So this is fairly simple, but it's also a little bit vague. Any other computer program, I would not expect it to be able to do this properly, but let's see what GPT-4 does. All right. So usually the first part of the output is going to be a little bit of an explanation. December is a Sunday, therefore you will need to make adjustments to the week. Okay, so you can see right here, weekly template, Monday through Saturday. I told it that earlier. Okay, so you can see here it actually split it up into two shifts for each day. We can modify that. I'm imagining, Shelley, that with your stuff, you probably just want it to be like one afternoon to evening shift or something like that. It's actually splitting it into three shifts. So, all right. Come on. Also, it's never done this to me before. It's actually giving us a template, essentially, that you can just keep alternating between. And then it's including the week of May 1st, since Jeff can't work on May 4th. We can swap his shifts with Sally's shift, blah, 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 blah. All right. This is different than what it gave me the other day, actually. It just spelled out an entire schedule from May 1st all the way through December 31st. I had to prompt it multiple times to get it to continue generating because it has a character cap on the amount of information it can, or the number of characters it can use for each response. So you'll notice that sometimes when you're prompting it, and what you can do then is just when it gets done with that portion of the response, just say, show me more, and it'll just keep feeding you more and more stuff. But all right, so we can see one problem right here, and that is that it's split the days into two or three shifts. I don't know why Friday has two shift threes, but I have no idea. But let's do something real quick. Change this to only one shift per day. Okay, so notice what I'm doing here. I'm talking to it like a human being. I'm not saying, anything. I'm not using specific language. I'm just talking to it colloquially. And, all right, there we go. So it immediately knows this is something that's really a lot of people haven't caught on to yet, but Chat GPT will use previous messages for context to respond to future messages. So it knows when I just said change this to only one shift per day, it just assumed I was talking about the schedule. When I said this, I didn't say specifically what this is, it just figured it out. So it's giving me the same type of response here. All right, perfect. All right, so let's change it up a little bit. Let's do May through July and include dates each day. So again, drawing from the context of our previous messages, it just keeps modifying it however I want. So here we go, May 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and you can see it's skipping Sunday. It did not put Roger on the 4th. Like it was supposed to, or it was not supposed to do, so it did what it was supposed to do there. So it's giving you, okay, all right, this is looking good, but let's say we want two people to work every day. Perfect. Now change it so that two people are working every day. Come on. It's still generating the last one. I shouldn't have told it through July. I'm just going to click stop generating. And all right, so we're getting closer to the schedule we want now. All right, so the first Monday, Roger, Jessica, Sally, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I'm going to let it finish generating May, and then I'm going to show you one more thing because although this is cool and could lead to you transferring this information over to a printed schedule, or maybe you just copy and paste this onto something else. A lot of people would prefer to have something like this turned into a table, for example, or a spreadsheet. Okay, so seems pretty vague, a little bit vague. I don't know. Let's see what it does with it. Okay, so it's following my directions so far. So the problem with this table is going to be that it doesn't have enough, ChatGPT doesn't have enough width to divide things out properly. It would probably be better to do this as a week. Let's do that as a week. So I'm going to copy this prompt, and this time I'm going to say first week of, and I bet this will look a lot better. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that's what I was looking for. So there is a limitation here in terms of like the space that it has to write things, and that seems kind of arbitrary given the fact that monitor resolutions are different, but it's not even using like a fifth of my monitor right now. So, but you know, it worked perfectly for a week. So here's the week schedule. Everybody has an X next to or in the cell for the day that they're working. And then you can just say, okay, now do this for the second week of May. And et voila. You have a table with the second week of May. So I could see a situation where you might want to just do this every week or do them all one week and print them out on separate pieces of paper for weekly schedules, something like that. If you could go wider with this, that would be great because then you could do 2 weeks at a time. But either way, the output that you've got here, you can either just copy it and paste it. You can screenshot it and dump it to a Word document. However you want to do it, the point is it generated the data for you. It figured the schedules out for you. Give it, you know, you can give it all of the days off that people need. I just gave it one person needing May 4th off, but you can also tell it like Sally needs the 5th, 6th, and 7th off, and Susie needs whatever, that kind of thing. But yep, all right, that was a longer video than I intended, but I hope it's helpful and that it gets you started with using ChatGPT. This is just one of the many, many, many helpful uses I've found for it. Just explore, play with it, talk to it, and see how it can help you. All right, let me know if you have any questions.